اللهم اجعلنا مستحقين نقول بالشكر على الذي في السماوات كل أيام حياتنا بكل سلام معفوفك كل حسد كل تجربة وعرف الناس الأشرار وخيال الأعداء انزعها عنا وعن سائر شعبك وعن موضعك المقدس والصالح والنفعات أعطينا السلطان أن ندوس الحياة بالنعمة والرأفة ومحبة الأفضل الواتي لابنك الوحيد المخلص يسوع المسيح من قبله المجد والكرامة والعزة والسلوك ويدك مع الروح القدس محي المساوي لك الآن وإلى الأبد ارحم يا الله برحمتك وصفتك اغسلني كثيرا من اسمي من خطيئتي طاهر
أرسل الله رحمته وحقه وخلص نفسي من بين الأشباه Yeah. فنحن بك نتوسل من
لأنك سيرة يشفع عن الفضيل
المخلص أيتها الأم طاهرة لا تفضل بعد عند الذي يرحم وطالع على الأخلاص
لأنه من أجلك كي ينقذنا فلتدركنا رحمة سريعا
لأننا قد تمسكنا بك
عند الله من أجل اسمك
يا
Tenite a te che soluziona sognona Samata khalas wasta ardu kulla
ayyuna sirana عندما وصلت إليك طاهرتين على عرض الصليب فجاءت كل الأمم تصر قائلة أن هكذا لك يا
مكسبت إليك إليك
أعين نعماتي
فاسد الصالح
من أخذ خطايانا أيها المسيح أنا
أسرت عن صلاتك نصرف إليك مشكورك لأنك بلغت الكل فرحا
أيها المخلص
أنت تعين العالم يا رب المجد كريم
Thank you.
مخوف العاد الذي ابنك الوحيد يسوع المسيح ربنا غير معفينا دونا ومناكلنا مع آفة القديسين أنت الآب غير المختلف والابن التساوي لنا والروح ارحمنا يا الله ثم ارحمنا لأن في كل وقت في الساعة في السماء مزبوط لهم منك تمسك لنا الصالح تبيد الروح الكثير الرحمة الجزيل التحمل الذي يحب الصديقين الذي هو المحمى الذي لا يشتاق موت الخاطي ثم يرجع ويحيا الدار كل الخلاص الموعد الخيرات المنتظرة يا رب ارضى لنا سنة الحياة شجع العمل وسلام قدس أرواحنا طاهر أجسامنا قوم أفكارنا نقي نيتنا اشفي أمراضنا اغفر خطايانا ناجينا من كل خزنة وتعطينا أحب ملائكتك القديسين الكريم كل معسكرهم محسنين ومشرفين لنصل إلى الاتحاد بالمال وإلى معاد الملك غير محسوس غير محدود فإنك مبارك إلى الأبد يا أبانا الذي يتقدس اسمك يأتي ملكوتك تكن مشيئتك كما في السماء كذلك على الأرض ورثنا
عشان يقول الاثنين
اي هني مش حاطه
له اي جابت
امير كان عنده 28 وماشي ميريلاند دلوقتي اديله 3 ساعات
انا هديله سوري يوصله بالسلامه
All three age groups, there are no servants.
وبعدين موضوع خاصة المؤتمر اللي سمعناها هنفهم لسه الكلمة معناها وكل تفاصيل وبعد أن هذا يبقى في تنبيهات وتنبيهات عشان يكون أكبر عدد حضر التنبيهات والتليفون لو رن هتدفعه $2 غير رقم فده ما فيهوش بالصح أرجوكم إيه عشان الدراسة مبقاش كل شوية حد يرن كده معلش نلتزم الالتزام ده من فضلكم طب نبتدي نسخن بالترتيلة كده طبعا الترتيلة بالنسبة لنا صلاة وكل ترتيلة فيها معاني روحية ترتيلة أدائية وأرثوذكسية تتناقش الكلمات كأنه قاعد مستني الوعظة على سبيل الصلاة وقطع
Thank you. This retreat is about Maran Atha, which means God is coming. The concept of this retreat that we need to be prepared to meet Christ, and all the saying from the Bible and elsewhere that God is very close. Period. It is Aramaic word. There will be sayings from the fathers about the services for whoever would like to participate, whether in Egypt or Africa or Asia. There will be also about Maran Atha. Period, new paragraph. We are going to start talking about sayings of the fathers about preparation. Every session will be talking about three sayings of the fathers. New paragraph. Theophan, the hermit. Is speaking about contradict your fathers, but try to obey them in every way. Do not oppose your teachers, especially for those who are trying to help you contradict your desires. My beloved, this is a very important concept, because even if you are trying to do a spiritual walk, but you are thinking you are doing the right thing, but because you are alone, you may be actually going in the wrong direction. It's very important that you obey your fathers and those who are trying to help you. To say yes, sometimes it is against your own will. For example, forgive your brother. Sometimes it may be against what you want or what you wish. But it is against your will, and that's what will help you. Your own will sometimes follow your own arrogance and your own desires. but to be submissive and to follow His will and to follow the Father of compassion and the commands of the Bible. The saying, do not oppose your fathers. One may say, I don't want to follow my father because he is an old man. You must try to obey and say yes and take the blessing of others. Try to say yes even if this is your heart, and try to obey them willingly. And the more you obey, the more you will get the blessing. For example, if your father told you, pray five psalms, and you follow that, if he tells you, increase your offering, obey, you will get more blessing. Hence, make your will and desire to follow, to obey. This will help you also to learn humility. Humility is not an easy virtue because it makes you come on yourself. It will help you to think more, to endure all the events that you are living in. But it is the most perfect way to heavens. Heavens. Arrogance is the mother of all sins. By you feeling better than others, and you do not need repentance, it's a very dangerous spot. Sometimes a father may be strict in his opinions, directions. It is like a tough person, but do not, and all what you want is to. Watch out from trying to think that the fathers are not understanding you or they are against you. You will not learn how to. And said, get ready to all time. Hear and accept the labors and hardships when facing tribulations. Not surrender yourself to a fainting heart or a weakened or else your striving will be worthless. Rather, be patient and put in your mind these things came because of my sins. Sometimes you face sufferings, sickness, events, issues. Don't give up and give in to grief and start saying, God is against me. Not good. Be patient and be steadfast in your thoughts. Tell yourself, this is coming upon me for my own sins. The best way to face some of these sufferings is to say, God is sending me this so He can clean me and He can cure me. God will give you more blessings and more wrath in you. The sufferings and the tribulations are getting less. It will fade away if you submit to the will of God and you feel and believe that you deserve and you need what is happening to you. Tell yourself that you are in need of this. Another saying to the same Father, the divine grace has withdrawn its consolation from you, but it stands closely watching you and will not leave you without help as long as your will is towards good. So be steadfast for this storm and it will end quickly. Sometimes when you face lukewarmness, that the grace had come back a bit. Remember that the divine grace will not leave you without help as long as your will is towards the good. It's very similar to a mother watching her son trying hard to walk and fall, but she always be ready to pick him up. Try to take some quiet time going to the Father of Confession. The grace will not leave you without help, so be steadfast for this storm and it will end quickly. Continue and do not stop trying. If you endure this trial and hardship, you will come out of it with a deeper knowledge of your weakness and humility. Sometimes you start feeling that you are better than others, but through this hardship and tribulation, you will come out of it stronger and you will be more humble. Hence, these periods of hardships will humble you and will make you understand that you are going to be better through the grace of God. So we learned three things. Tell your father yes and submit to him and hold in the obedience and learn humility and do not follow your own desires. Two, if you face sufferings and desires, please be ready, steadfast. Also, when you face look, be ready to be steadfast. These are the experiences of the fathers. We are going to sing the song. Song, second mile, because the second mile is to endure going to sing a song. Exactly as the mountain is above, praying for you. Thank you. I have a question. I would like you to help me answering it. So, someone is hurting my feelings and making me angry. What do you think I should do? So you'll stop thinking of the past and the present. How can you oppose your thinking in order for you not to be overwhelmed, becoming more excited and angry? So one answer is, remember that God loves you even though you are sin. What else? What can I do when God, when someone hurting me, making me angry? Another way is to remember Jesus' prayer. Jesus, please help me. Jesus, please help me. Again, what can I do with my head when it's making me angry at people or acting? Maybe I should remember the story of Jesus who forgave someone, forgave another slave, but then couldn't accept to forgive his brother. And then the king brought the first one because he did not forgive his own brother. Remember excuses and try to give excuses to your brother. Himself is under an issue. Maybe that himself have deceived. Also, push yourself to do something, even it. Make yourself for him, and know even though say even though it's not easy. Review even and search your own self. Maybe you are the one to be and the other person.
Other فران والتسامح هيساعدنا. حد يضيف حاجة تاني؟ تفضلي علي صوتك.
Remember verses about anger. Like the anger of a man does not give righteousness of God. Being angry does not make you a city. Where the thoughts are coming from. reach out. If it's to forgiveness and endurance, then it's from God. You need to select your thoughts. You need to choose which thought you want. Let's assume he believed. Maybe I should say, maybe one day I also offend and I wanted people to forgive me. Shouldn't I forgive him now? Forgive him later time? I remember for that part so I'm sinning so much. Watch out, some people like to blame the public by telling you worse things and make you feel bad about yourself and speaking worse, feeling worse about the person ahead of you. Rana is speaking about the services that's happening, which is called for children. He's helping children who are able to finish their education. Which is parallel to the, and now they can go to multiple educational levels. Also have another program which is over 500 services of children, help them.
رميد جرحي إلى أن يتوب رأيته ينزل من فوق الصليب ويرقب رجوعي له من بعيد ودمه كان بعيد شفاء وحبا حياة وبر لمن يريد، فكيف أظن لا يستجيب، فكيف أظنه لا يستجيب، فيما أظن لا يستجيب، يرتب أمرا حبيبا
يحلق يؤذي ويؤذي ليبيك يصنع عهدا جديد، يظل امينا وديعا قريب، فيعجب قلبي بحب عزيز وحينا يطول الليل الرقيق، اراه يضيء امامي أمامي بابا جديد، فكيف أظنه لا يستجيب، فكيف أظنه لا يستجيب، يطهر قلبي منير السبيل، يأخذ سلطانا على المستحيل، يكثف دمعي ويرفع على كتفيه بطول المسير، نظرت إليه بعين العبيد، فما لكفي الرب العظيم، يهرع لعوني ويعرف ودعي ويدعوني إلى المني، فكيف أظنه لا يستجيب، فكيف أظنه لا يستجيب، وفيما أظنه لا يستجيب، يرتب أمرا عجيبا رهيبا، يحلق يؤذي ويطفي اللهيب، بيديك يصنع عهدا جديد، يظل امينا وديعا قريب، فيحمل قلبي بحب العبيد، وحين يطول الليل الرقيق، اراه يضيء امامي قريب، ويفتح امامي بابا
start the first lecture about Maran Atha. It's an Aramaic word which means a greeting word saying God is coming. It's also when you say Christ is risen, it's also another greeting word to say Maran Atha or God is coming. People who are simple may not know Allah, but they can easily know Maran Atha. So that's why Saint Paul put it exactly it to be said. Aramaic way at the end of the epistle to the Romans, speaking it instead of using Hebrew or Roman language, but rather he used it as is in Aramaic, and it was transmitted to other languages in the same way it used to be uttered. And even when it is written in Arabic, it was written the same way as it used to be spoken. One of its meanings, it is called the coming. We always say, blessed the one who is coming. Christ is the blessed one who is coming. Blessed means we give him the blessing. Let us now think about the way it's written as the coming. One of the means the Lord is near. And he used the same way to the Philippians.
The Lord is at hand, or is very near. لكن هي أصلها هذا أقرب إلى كلمة جاي أو فيه أو هيجي.
It means God is either came, coming, or is here. It can also mean please come. You can respond to the person who is telling you Maran Atha by telling him back Maran Atha, which means yes, please come, Lord. Come, Lord. But if one of us, if he is reluctant and lazy, he will not like the coming of the Lord. So the verb means here that the Lord is or has come. In 1 Corinthians 16, anyone does not love the Jesus. Oh Lord, come. Meaning, if anyone does not love Christ, he is cursed. So this was almost the constitution of the first century. So the person who is cursed or rejected, who is not interested in the coming of the Lord. If you truly love God, you wait for him. Waiting for the groom to come, as we say in the creed. Creed. It's also similar to what we say in liturgy. Alleluia. And it can be sung in many different ways. But we love the word regardless of the season because it results in our understanding. As we read in Revelation 1, blessed is he who reads, and those who hear the words of this prophecy, and keep those things which are written in it, for the time is near. John to the seven churches which are in Asia, grace to you and peace from him who is, and who was, and who is to come, and from the seven spirits who are before his throne.
Who was and who is to come. اللي فكرة مران آسة يعني هو جه ولسه جاي. جدي ترجع المسيح لأن احنا دلوقتي محصورين بين مجيئين.
We are in between two comings. In the first coming, when he came in the beginning of the New Testament, and at the end, there will be the second coming. And that's why in the Coptic liturgy, priest moves at the end of the litany, showing he comes from one side, stating that he came, then he goes to the altar and comes from the other side, stating that he is coming again. We are living and believing that he came and he is coming. Being who is, or Jehovah, is a very important term in the Old Testament. In John 8, our Lord said, "Most assuredly I say to you, before Abraham was, I am." The being is one of the names of our Lord in the initial and original language. He is being in his own self. They took up stones to throw him because that was a revelation of his own self. In Revelation 1, I am the Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. He says he is coming with the clouds, and every eye will see him, and even they who pierced him, and all the tribes of the earth will mourn because of him. Even so. In the beginning of the gospel, the Pharisees went to our Lord asking him a question. Are you the coming one? What does this mean? The Jews are still waiting for a certain one. The Messiah to them is the coming one. The coming one does not belong to anyone, but only to the Messiah. And that's why the coming one only means God himself is coming and belongs only to the Messiah. And that's why they went to John the Baptist asking him, "Are you the coming one?" And immediately he responded saying, "Of course I am not, but the one who comes after me, he is the coming one." And that's why he responded saying, "The one who comes after me, he is before me. He is the original, he is the eternal." In the Old Testament, the coming one is present in many places. He is in Psalm 118. He says, "He who comes in the name of the Lord, we have blessed you from the house of the Lord." And that's the song that is being sung during their feasts. But to us, the Messiah already came, because we are saying it joyfully, because to us he already came. To them, they are praying for his coming. In the New Testament, in the Palm Sunday, the simple Jews who are not the Pharisees and the Sadducees, they believe that Jesus is the coming one, and that's why they came believing and blessing, saying, Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. It's very clear to us that the coming is our Lord. He came and saved us. And that's the shortest creed in Christianity. And Isaiah said the same. He will come and save us. We have waited for him. He came and saved us. In Isaiah 40, you who bring good things, get up into high mountain Jerusalem. You who bring good tidings, lift up your voice with strength. Lift it up and do not be afraid. Maran Atha, God have come. And that's why in liturgy we say also, because we say the one we have been waiting for is in front of us, in front of the altar. Behold, the Lord God shall come with a strong hand. And his arms shall work for him. Behold, his reward is with him. He will feed his flock like a shepherd. He will gather the lambs with his arm and carry them in his bosom. I apologize, there is a theological and a spiritual aspect to this retreat. Because he came and he is coming. As we read, it is not possible that the blood of bulls and goats could take away sins. Sacrifice and offering you did not desire, but a body you have prepared for me. This is a very unique psalm, and the Jews call it a messianic psalm. Jesus is telling the Father, you do not like offering, but you are asking me to become the body, the sacrifice, to be offered. And in Hebrews 10 we continue reading, Behold, I have come in the volume of the book as it is written of me, to do your will, O God. Sacrifice and offering, burnt offerings for sin you did not desire, nor had pleasure in them. So we do not have many offerings anymore, no need for so many sacrifices, because the coming one has come. He is the main offering. And that's why in Palm Sunday, each Jew would come with his own offering. But when he entered Jerusalem, he was the main offering for the whole creation. He entered in a procession as if he is representing all the offerings that's being offered, and there is no need anymore for any goat or sheep to be offered. Daniel in Daniel 7 saw the Lord, and he said, I was watching in the night visions, and behold, one like the Son of Man coming with the clouds of heaven. He came to the Ancient of Days. This is a very important word, Maran Atha, because it's different than any other dogma or religion. Because our Lord already come, and he is with us. He came to us. He came for our salvation. He came down from heaven. He was incarnated and became man.
And that's why we are waiting for him to come back. The Son of Man coming with the clouds of heaven, he came to the ancient days and they brought him near before him. Then to him was given dominion and glory. That's all people, nations. His dominion is everlasting dominion, shall not pass away, and his kingdom shall not be destroyed. In Micah, for behold, the Lord is coming out of his place. He will come down and will tread on high places. Our Lord will come as incarnated man. Lord. In Psalm 96, he is coming to judge the earth. Another sentence, this is in Hebrew language, means that we have seen him, meaning incarnated. When we say this is him, that means he was incarnated. And that's what happened during the baptism in the Jordan River. And we have heard this once during the baptism in Jordan and another time during the Transfiguration, which is the revelation and the transfiguration of our Lord witnessed by his own Father. And that's why our Lord said, if we accept the witness of people, shouldn't we accept the witness of God the Father? He is coming to say, this is my beloved Son. When our Lord is speaking about the Eucharist, the people believed in him, the simple ones, and they said, this is truly the prophet who is coming into the world. When they say the prophet, it's not like any prophet, but the prophet and the coming are synonymous for our Lord. To give uniqueness to the prophet makes him not anyone but the one. Not even John the Baptist could be called the prophet. But our Lord, he is the prophet, but he is the coming into the world. You may not know this, but when you have the word witness, and especially in the Gospel of John, that Jesus is being witnessed by heavens, that he is the true one who is coming. Especially in John 5, he speaks a lot about the witness, that Jesus, the Son of God, he is the coming one who came to save us. And that's why we read in John 5, I have a greater witness than John's. John the Baptist witnessed that Jesus is the one who I have seen the Holy Spirit descending upon him. He is the Savior. He is the true Son of God. I have a greater witness than John's, for the works which the Father has given me to finish, the very works that I do bear witness of me. When we speak about the theology of Jesus Christ, His works prove his deity. Remember the prophets asked God to give them help to do miracles, that our Lord does miracles in his own name. But anyone will do it in the name of God.
وهي الأعمال بعينها التي أنا أعمل هي تشهد لي أن الأب قد أرسل والأب نفسه الذي أرسلني يشهد لي.
The Father had sent me. He with their witness of me, and the Father himself who sent me has testified of me. You have neither heard his voice at any time, nor seen his form. This passage has how many times he mentioned witness. The works witness, John the Baptist witness, the Father witness, the Father witness, the works witness, and John the Baptist witness. And there is a fourth one. And then he says, search the scriptures, and they are also witnessing for him. So we have four types of witnesses that Jesus is the coming one. The prophets, and on top of them John the Baptist, his works, the Father, and the scriptures. And this is, of course, the beginning of Christianity. The initial creed was very small and simple, that Jesus is the Son of God. And all the scriptures were written to prove that Jesus is God, and you have an eternal life in him. And that's why Jesus Christ is the coming one. And that's why all of this were summarized in one word, which is Maran Atha. The Lord has come to us, and that's why it was the most important greeting. And he came for the salvation of the world. Our Lord has used it many times in his own teachings. In John 16, he said, I came forth from the Father, and I have come into the world. And also I leave the world and go to the Father. I have come in my Father's name, and you do not receive me. Because some people claim that Jesus came in his own word, but he came sent by the Father. The Father has sent the Son, and both the Father and the Son are one. In John 10, he says, I have come that they may have life, and they may have it more abundantly. So there is no life outside Jesus Christ. If you do not have faith in Jesus Christ, you have no life outside him. And that's why this greeting was the main greeting, because it summarizes the whole faith. And that's why the word, you have come, we repeat it so many times in Eucharist. And that's why the Coptic priest sometimes takes time and sing it when he uses the word, you have come. For us, this is the most important word, because we are not waiting for another coming anymore. You have come to us on earth. You have come into the womb of the Virgin. And another time we say, you have came to the slaughter as a sheep. So the objective of the coming, the objective of incarnation is our salvation. As a meditation, when you think that God is still in heaven, you may feel very scared. Mary and Martha were waiting for Jesus to come and he didn't. And they were very scared and they had death. And they were suffering and grieving. But when Jesus arrived, in their opinion, late, so everyone told them the teacher had come, John 11:28. And he told them, as long as I came, there is no more death. I am the resurrection. The word the teacher has come had opened their eyes that there is no more waiting and there is no more grieving. Sometimes God appears as if he's coming late, but that's why we need to celebrate that he is always here. I am not waiting anymore for him. He is in me. He is with me. The presence of God removes despair, removes grieving, removes fear, and gives rather joy, resurrection, and happiness. And that's why the word Maran Atha is a very joyful term. And some people claim that this word was a greeting for those who are martyrs. So they celebrate the martyrdom of anyone by telling his beloved Maran Atha that Jesus is coming. And we celebrated that there is an end to the fear, an end to the injustice in the world, an end to the unfairness by telling each other Maran Atha, that God will take care of business. Let me summarize and conclude by saying the church verbalized Maran Atha in the Lord's Prayer, as if you are telling God, please God come, I have fear, I have unfairness, I am scared, I am in despair. But by you saying the Lord's Prayer, right away you calm yourself down that God is near. Why would you be scared? Why would you be afraid if God is near? And that's why at the end of the book of Revelation, he will say, come soon, Lord. And that's why we should have the faith of the children. When we say, your dad is coming, you are not scared that God is coming, because when he is coming, I am sure he is coming with a very good present and gift. If you have the faith of the children, you will not be scared. And as we read in Matthew 18, you become like children. Because if you accept the kingdom of God as a child, to you, Maran Atha now becomes a real and reality. Let us think throughout the retreat, am I really waiting for that meeting or not? Is it really coming to my mind or not? He promised he's coming, and he came so many times to my life, and he covered up for my weaknesses so many times. But one day I'm going to meet him face to face. above the clouds, and every eye will see him. And with that hope, we will remember him. May God bless you all. Amen.
بالمناسبة المكتبة اللي بره كل منتجاتها
اكتب اللي انت
هتروح لخدمة
المرور التنبيهات عايز تكتبها هنا
شو
هنا
عشان اعرف بشكر كل اللي بيتعبوا كل شهر المؤتمر لكن كل ده بيروح للخير بيروح للخدمة في الصعيد الحاجات كمان هتلاقوا البوس بتاع
عشان ده بيعمل فويس
عايز اديها لك دي بسبب الخدمات المجانيه اللي بتقدمها المؤسسه لانها طبعا كلها بتستخدم الروح يعني دكاترتنا المسيحيين وبتوصل
احنا على الاقل نوريهم دي دلوقتي
يعني
انا لغايه ما
هي نانسي غالبا هتقول التعليمات بعد المحاضرة التانية هي عايزة تجهز حاجات تانية بس عشان بس نحسن تكونوا قلقانين شوية لو سمحتوا خدوا كاميرا قصدي بيكتشر من سكان للكيو ار كود هتنزلوا المؤتمر كله احتفاظا ان احنا ما نبوظش الشجر اللي في العالم فبدل ما نطبع ونترمي فلو سمحتوا خدوا اول ما تعملوا الكاميرا عليها بيحصل زي كادر كده اصفر تدوسوا عليه بيداونلود المؤتمر كله اعتقد ممكن تعملوها من مكانكم وممكن نحطها برضو على السكرين البعيده لو ما قدرتوش هي محطوطه في كل حته في تقريبا 50 كيو ار كود موجود في كل الاوض في كل الحيطان بره فاللي مش قادر يعملها دلوقتي يعملها بره ده بالنسبه للموضوع ده اللي عنده استعداد يخدم معانا جوه المؤتمر بالذات في حاجه اسمها نايت واتش يعني اسم الصليب برضو نشكر ربنا عندنا اولاد كتير وجايز يسهروا وجايز يلعبوا وجايز يخبطوا على الاوض فلو في اباء عايزين يساعدونا لو سمحت يقولوا لي في نهايه اليوم النهارده يعني ممكن نعمل شيفتات بحيث اللي يقدر يسهر يبقى كتر خيره عشان بس ما نزعجش الناس وما نزعجش الناس اللي عايزه تنام النهارده بقيه التعليمات بعد اذنكم هنقولها بعد كده لو عايزين تعرفوا المؤتمر ممكن تحط السكرين المؤتمر برودكاست على لوجوس تي في على فادر داود يوتيوب شانل على وان فلوك وان شيبرد اللي هي الكوميتي الاورجنايزيشن بتاعت المؤتمر وعلى سي واي سي فويس اوفر يعني في ترجمة فورية بتحصل لكل حاجة ابونا بيقولها بالعربي اذا كانت اسئلة او سايينجز اوف يعني اقوال القديسين او محاضرات فاللي عنده ناس عايزين يسمعوا بالانجلش يدخلوا على سي واي سي طيب برضو تنبيه واحد بس اللي بيبقى عاوزني في 5 دقايق ماكسيمم 5 دقايق لقيت اسمه الدكتور جابي اكسكيوز مي وقفي معلش الدكتور جابي بتاخد الاسماء بس اللي عاوز مني دقايق فقط وبيبقى لنا في روم مخصوص للميتينجز
عايزين نلاقي روم هنلاقي روم
يعني هناخد جنب دلوقتي ونتكلم وبنأجل الصور لو سمحتوا ليها معاد يعني موضوع ان احنا ناخد
فوتوز أظن هيتعمل فوتو سيشن بحيث يبقى سريع شوية، نشكر الله أغلب المصريين ما بيعرفوش يصوروا فبتبقى الحكاية يعني جهدها صعبة شوية. نعم حبيبي، إيه ده؟ الأسئلة بعد إذنك هتتلم يعني في خلال البريك، ممكن تتحط بقى في وقت البريك بقى ونتعامل معها في أول السيشن الجاي. معانا ساعة، ممكن ساعة بريك طويل كده عشان اللي ما استلمش الغرف أو لسه عنده أي استفسارات. هنرجع على 2:15 بعد إذنكم، 2:15 لو سمحت، بس خدوا من فضلكم الصورة عشان يبقى البرنامج نازل على موبايلاتكم. الحمد لله على السلامة ليكم كلكم، تعيشوا كل يوم طبيعي.
كل الهابس ايه؟ في واحد دلوقتي كبير، واحد بس.
I'm going to go to the next one.